Hello and welcome back. You're watching Parry This.
Today we will be doing another Kingdom Come Deliverance lore video, this one covering Sir Radzig Kobola. I will be referencing much information from the game and much from external sources. Whenever able, I will reference examples or aspects of the game so the information is easy to process. With all of this in mind, this information will contain potential spoilers for the game, so consider yourself warned. And let's get into it. Like many knights and lords from lower houses in medieval times, there is little detail about Sir Radzig. In Czech, Radzig. But since I don't speak Czech, we will be sticking with Radzig Kobola. And just a warning now, it is likely that I will butcher a great many pronunciations in this video, so I am sorry in advance. But I will do my best. But anyway, like I said, there is little known about this lord. And that is likely because, unlike kings or great warlords, he did little that historians found worth mentioning. And much of what is known, we have from stories which have been passed on through word of mouth, and therefore can easily be called into question. However, this video will be my best attempt to tell the life and times of Sir Radzig Kobola. I could not find a reliable source that said exactly where or when Sir Radzig was born, but his title was Radzig Kobola of Dvojets, I think is how you pronounce that. And I would think that Dvojets was his birthplace, but I could find no reference to it anywhere, other than a modern Czech word, Dvojeti, which translates to mean double. So I don't know what to make of that. So I say, do with that what you will. Where it was easy to pick up his story was 1403, where he resided at the castle in Silver Skelets, or Stichiberna Skelice. Here he was responsible for governing as local lord of the area, in-game locations including Skelets, Ravna, and Merhoyed. His responsibilities included recruitment, training, and retention of fighting men, administering law and order, and protection of all his fief's residents, collecting taxes, and counseling his liege, Wenceslaus IV. However, above all of this was the administration, expansion, and operations of the Skelets silver mine, which was one of the richest silver mines in Wenceslaus's domain, and provided much of the king's revenue in the region. So although it wasn't the most prestigious posting or luxurious fief in Bohemia, it can be gathered from this posting that Wenceslaus trusted Radzig and had great faith in his abilities. It was at this time that Radzig was also named as Wenceslaus's royal hetman. Now, if you're like me, and not a scholar in medieval culture or terminology, then this term may have gone over your head, or simply registered as a title that is probably important, but not necessary for you to know specifically what it meant. But it is actually rather impressive, so we're going to dig into it a little bit. So the best information of what this actually entailed that I could find said two things. One was that after the Hussite Wars, this term lived on and was the title for the elected governor of a Czech region. However, at the time of Sir Radzig's life, it was a military position that served as second-in-command to the king. This information helped me make sense of a lot of the events in the game and, bring them into context. I had wondered why it seemed like Hanish and Divish just gave Radzig their own garrisons and even joined him in several battles seen throughout the game. I assumed that this was merely a plot device to drive the action, and since Radzig no longer held his own fief and had lost many of his men, that this was the only way to show battle in the game. But now, knowing what being the royal hetman meant, I understand. They were duty-bound to obey his commands in military matters, so they really didn't have a choice. They had to give Radzig their men. This is a great example of the assertion that many historians have made that Wenceslaus was prone to appointing high titles and honors to lower nobles of small or poor houses in exchange or as a reward for loyalty. This practice, of course, paid off in many cases, but was also often seen as Wenceslaus rewarding his friends in preference to higher noble houses. It is speculated that much of what Radzig received, especially early in life, was due to his supposed close friendship with King Wenceslaus. In 1403, however, the town of Silver Skelets was besieged and burned to the ground by King Sigismund of Hungary and his great Cuman horde, which was involved in the family war of Wenceslaus and Sigismund, which we won't dig into too deeply here. Suffice it to say, it was one of many events at the time, and the end result was simply that many people died, and Radzig lost much, and he was forced to move on. Since Radzig had been a loyal servant to Wenceslaus for many years, he was permitted to build his own castle at Veseli nad Sazavou, which was renovated into a chateau in the Renaissance. That chateau stands to this day and is called the Chateau Komorny Hradec. However, this is not where Sir Radzig's career ended. In 1410, he was appointed as the Burgrave of Wieshrad. Now, a Burgrave is simply the hereditary ruler of a Bohemian town or castle. In this case, it was a castle. Specifically, Wieshrad Castle, which was the upper castle for the city of Prague. For reference, picture Rethei, but the city is much larger, and instead of the small castle being at the bottom, the small castle is the upper castle. But also, the small castle is the size of the two Rethei castles combined. So it was, you know, much larger. It served as support to the larger Prague Castle, which was approximately 3 kilometers northwest of Wieshrad. In those days, Burgraves were also known as Princes of the Empire, which gave them a quasi-royal significance. Of course, since their positions were appointed, they could of course be removed by the king at any time. Unlike the higher position, the Burgrave of Prague, which was at the time Sir Divish of Talmberg, which was usually a lifetime appointment. But in essence, the title of Burgrave was essentially a viceroy to the king for the region. In simple terms, this was much like the office of the Hand of the King in Game of Thrones. In literal terms, it translates directly to mean in place of the king. This office is supreme in the territory second only to the king, and above all others. So by all historical accounts I could find, he served in this office from 1410 to 1415. However, it was after this where things got a little blurry. The end of Sir Radzig's life is well known and documented, as it was public and for the time well publicized. It is, however, his life leading up to his death that is at question. The cause for confusion amongst historians here is that Sir Radzig held the office of Burgrave of Wieshrad from 1410 to 1415. However, there were also reports that in 1410, 7 years after his estate at Silver Scallops was destroyed, he had established himself as a prominent robber baron, which is essentially the equivalent of a modern-day crime syndicate leader, or mob boss. Basically, he hired and led men in various criminal activities, usually robbing travelers, merchants, and raiding towns for loot. This was not unusual for nobles down on their luck and out of money, especially when they were, I don't know, trying to do something very expensive, like build a new castle even though they don't have a legitimate source of income because it was burned down by an invading Hungarian monarch. So at that time, 1410 for reference, a detachment of soldiers from the king's retinue was dispatched against Radzig and his men to bring them to justice, as he was seen as the scourge of the land. And then, inexplicably, he was later rehabilitated and given his high-ranking office and the Burgravate of Wieshrad for, quote, services to the king, unquote. So this bit of unclear history aside, Sir Radzig met his end in 1416, when he was killed by an angry mob of miners at a tavern in Kutnahora. He was reportedly there on the king's business, collecting the taxes for the region. The attack was inspired by preachers as retribution against royal officials for the burning of the religious revolutionary Jan Hus, who had been executed as a heretic a year prior. The quote that follows is the historical account of how he died. Quote, "They seized them in the inn where they were staying, cut their bodies into pieces, and threw them out onto the street, where the mob vigorously stomped on their remains and went into merry song to the home of the preacher to be praised for the act they had been encouraged to commit," unquote.
Boy, that escalated quickly. I mean, that really got out of hand fast.
Sir Radzig was one of many nobles to be killed around this time in various skirmishes and small-scale uprisings leading up to what would later become known as the Hussite Wars. Unlike in the game, I could find no records of any children to Sir Radzig Kobla, legitimate or otherwise. It is likely that if he had any children, they were killed or any reference to them was destroyed or lost in the Hussite Wars. Well, that does it for the life and times of Sir Radzig Kobla. I will admit, the information I used in this video was harder to come by than I thought it would be, and in many instances, I drew heavily from the information given in the game. For my attempt to have this video be as historically accurate as possible, I didn't include any extraneous information that I couldn't verify. That's why I didn't include anything about Hagen Zul from the game, because I couldn't find any historical reference to a conflict there. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up and a comment, or even share would be much appreciated, as videos like this take a long time to research and also to edit. But in any case, thank you for watching and have a nice day. I will see you next time.
Congrats.